If you've been following along with my garden update series for 2020, then you'll know about my monster chilli plant that I have growing inside a grow tent. It's inside an Ebb and Flood Hydroponics system that I designed and built. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how I did that. You're going to first need some boxes. This one here will be used for the reservoir. You need quite a big box so that you don't have to keep changing out the nutrients all the time. This one cost about £10 from IKEA with the lid, so it's about $12-13 US. And this one here will be for on top, which is where the grow media will be, as well as the plant. And that was about £6 or about $8-9 US. To keep this simple, in this video, I'm gonna just be using a normal off-the-shelf timer. That'll make life a lot easier for you rather than having to try and build a system. I will be building something for this, but I know that not everyone wants to go and do some coding and create little electronic devices. So you can just buy one of these timers. Make sure it's digital so that you can control the minutes. Some of the mechanical ones only allow you to do half hour increments, and that's going to be way too much for what we're going to be doing. So timer, we're going to need a small pump. I got a mains voltage pump. So this is just a small aquarium pump or a water feature pump. And I think that cost me about £5 or £6. So they really are not expensive. We're going to need some pipe to connect to the pump. This here is a 3D printed part that I designed, and it's available to download if you're on my Patreon on a particular tier. So if you do want to print this, you can go and download it there. It is a scaled up version of one that I designed last year for a smaller system that I had running inside my greenhouse. So you probably would have seen that a few times. I did talk about it during my grow update series. And that's just scaled up and reinforced in a few places, so it should be a bit stronger, but the one from last year was actually perfectly fine as well. Essentially what this allows me to do is easily pump water up through this and flood the system, and then drain quite easily back down without things like that blocking up any of the holes. So you can see there's some holes everywhere at the top as an overflow, and yeah, it works quite well and I'm pretty happy with it. And then we're going to need a few of these nylon nuts and bolts, and you'll see what those are for in just a second. Lastly, you're going to need a drill, and you're going to need a few bits which are going to help you with actually putting this all together. The basic concept of how the system will work, there is this little space over here which this fits over perfectly, but instead of letting it move around, we're going to actually secure it with these little guys over here. So we need to drill some holes underneath, and we're going to get that secured to the top of this. Then the one change I have made to this system, or the change I'm going to make, is the fact that in the one that I have inside the grow tent, I have two of these sitting on there. The challenge comes when this starts getting bigger, it gets quite difficult to open this up and actually service this. Also, I don't need two of these on here because the plants grow so big as it is. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna have one positioned over here. This side here, well, I'm just gonna cut it so it's a bit of a flap, and it'll allow me to very easily change out the nutrients, clean it up, and do any sort of servicing I need to do. If you want, you can put a dab of silicone in between the screws and the plastic, but honestly, I haven't seen any problems. There's been no leaking or anything. The next thing we need to do is place this. Because we're only going to have one plant in here, don't go and place it in the middle, because ideally you want your plant in the middle so that it can spread its roots nicely. So with this, put it towards the one end and that'll be perfect. So I think around about there. Drill it from the bottom, because as you can see, there's a bit of a honeycomb design at the bottom here. So drill in between one of the honeycomb patterns, and it'll make life a lot easier for you. And again, you can put some silicone down there if you want. I really haven't noticed any problems with it, but that's up to you. Good place to put it is just around the edge here. And we can see this part here actually comes out, it's removable. And it was just because it made it a lot easier to print if you could do this separately. And that just slots in there. It's a nice tight fit, so it shouldn't be going anywhere. So let's test this little pump and see how it does. I'm fairly confident it'll be fine. I haven't actually tested this specific one. I'll try a variety, whatever's cheap at the time, so it's easy to replace if there are any problems. But let's give this one a go. And there we go. We can see it coming through quite easily, so more than happy with that. Of course, this is going to fill up a lot quicker when the clay pebbles are in here, but this is just to do a quick test, make sure the pump's working. Ebb and flood or flood and drain systems are quite simple to understand and they work very well, especially for my chili plants. I really enjoy this, and there's quite a few other big growers that use the same process. And essentially what it's doing is it floods the media, and then once you switch off the pump, which I'll do now, all the water is going to drain back through the pump, and there you go, it's your drain or your ebb. So let's test to see how long it takes for the water level to reach to just below that overflow pipe. There's a problem. This timer can only measure hours and minutes. So when we set a timer interval, I can only set it to go for 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, etc. This took 1 minute 26 to fill up. What we need to do is try and get it to take 2 minutes. And that's one of the benefits of this specific pump. So if you are going to do it this way, I would make sure that you have a pump like this, which you can set how much flow rate or power it'll actually put out. Because that way you can turn it down and get it to a point that this takes 2 minutes to fill this up. One of the reasons I like to use my automation, my microcontrollers, is I have a far better control over how long I can switch these things on for. So I can do it down to the millisecond if I really wanted to. I had to turn the pump all the way down to be able to get this to fill up in 2 minutes so that I can actually use this thing. You might get lucky and you might have a timer that can do seconds as well, then you don't have to fiddle around like I've just done. Now, of course, I've kept this very simple. I know a lot of you don't want to go too advanced with something like this and start fiddling with microcontrollers and servers and things like that. But I'll talk through some of the things I'm going to be doing to this to make it just that much better. It does require obviously a little bit of electronics knowledge, but it'll make things so much easier. The first thing will be to put a horizontal float switch over here. And what that'll do is when the water level gets below a certain point, it'll trigger my microcontroller and that will send me a message via email or Twitter or anything like that. And I'll get an alert saying that I need to come and top this up. The other thing I'm going to do, of course, is put the microcontroller in place so that I can turn the pump back up to full. I want this to flood as quickly as it can because that's just much better for the plant. You don't want it to take too long. And that's about it, really. There are a couple other things you can do. You can go put a heating element inside here if it is winter time where you are. Keep the water at a nice 27, 28 degrees Celsius. This is the plant that I'll be putting inside this hydroponic system. It's a bit of a special one. It's a cross I'm in the middle of creating between a Piri Piri and an Ahi lemon drop. That's a nice root system, and I'm sure it will do even better once we have it in the proper hydroponic system. This is now planted and it's going to be much happier being able to spread its roots. I've got one last thing to do. I need to mix up the nutrient solution I'm going to be using. I am using the general hydroponics nutrients and I'm just going to mix it up as per the recommendations on the bottle. Nothing too special there. I will adjust the pH as well, just to make sure that it's a little bit on the acidic side, around about 6, 6.5. There you go, the plant is in its final place. The lights are on the timer, 18 hours on, 6 hours off. And I'm sure we're going to see a lot of progress over the next few weeks and over the course of the year. Make sure that you are subscribed if you want to see the progress of this plant in this system. I will update you guys on my garden update series, and that comes out every few weeks. I hope that you learned something. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer. And until the next video, stay safe and stay spicy.